Hi everyone. So coming to the next topic, that is how many ways we can declare cascading style sheets in HTML. So we say that with the help of the HTML, you can make that HTML document with more looking and a beautiful formatting by using cascading styles. So there are different ways we can declare the cascading style sheets in HTML. Let's see that. The cascading style sheet is added to HTML pages to format the document according to information in the style sheet. So that is a main use of using the CSS to change the format of the document according to the information in the style sheet. There are three ways in to insert the cascading style sheets in HTML document. So in the HTML document, you can insert the cascading style sheets in the three ways. One is inline cascading, or you can go for internal cascading or external cascading. Let's see what are these three ways, how you are going to insert these cascading style sheets in HTML document. The first one is an inline cascading style sheet. So it is used to apply cascading style sheet on a single line. On a single line or a element. In line means the style sheet is going to be applied on a single line or with a single element. So whatever the element or whatever the line that you want to be represent stylishly, so that line, if you apply the style on that particular line, then you call it as a inline. So this was a syntax. Let's take P is a paragraph. And the style is equal to color. So style is a property attribute and the color is a pink is a value. And this statement welcome CSS is going to be print in a pink color. Okay, so this statement you call it as inline cascading style sheet. So this is the one way you can call the insert CSS in HTML document. And the next one is the internal cascading style sheet. Internal cascading style sheet is used to apply CSS on a single document or a page. So in previous inline means I am saying that it is a single statement, okay, single line. Inline is a single line or you can apply a style on an element. But internal means single document or complete page. A complete page or a complete document that can be represented by applying the styles. Okay, that complete page can be view in the form of stylish. Okay, so that you call it as internal cascading style sheet. It can affect all the elements of the page. So in the page, so many elements are there. So that style is going to be affect to all the elements in the page. It is written inside the style tag within a head section of HTML. So here I have written the complete program. So document HTML, HTML head. So the cascading style sheets, you have to be written the style tag inside the head section. So style. So here, whatever the body, that complete document or a page, that body color should be yellow. It should be represented in yellow color. And the whatever the heading that I am using in the body, that heading should be appeared in pink color. So close the style tag. So where whatever the statements that I am using on the body, so that complete body of means the complete pages should be displayed in yellow color. Okay, so the whenever I open the page is completely filled with yellow color. Okay, it's completely filled with yellow color. And it displays the H1 welcome to CSS in which color? H1 should be displayed in pink color. So what is its statement? Welcome to CSS. So this will be the output. This type of statements you call it as an internal cascading style sheets. So this is the one way of inserting CSS in HTML. And the next way is external CSS. External means we are just calling the external file in your HTML document. It is used to apply cascading style sheets on multiple pages or all pages, whereas inline is only single statement, whereas internal means a complete document or a page, whereas external means multiple pages or on all pages. External is going to be apply the cascading style sheets for all the pages in your website. If you want to change the complete pages in your website, should be the background color should be the same color, then you can go save the file in means you can use external cascading style sheets. It can be written in any text editor. The file should not contain HTML tags. So you need to write external cascading style sheet in any one of the editor, and no need to write the HTML tags there. Just use the style tags there and just call that link in your HTML document. So whatever the external cascading style sheet you are writing, that file should be saved with .cs extension. So here I have written some program. Just see, I'm just open one of the text editor and save the file as style.css. So up to now we just save the files in .html, but in the same text editor I am saving one of the file as style.css. So in that style.css I am not writing the HTML tags. I am just excluding the HTML tags. In the CSS I just written body, background color is blue and the H1 color is pink. So wherever the headings H1 is there in my website, that H1 heading color should be pink, and all the pages in my website or in all pages should be colored, background color is blue. So now I want to call this page in my HTML document with the help of link. So just see, document type, HTML, head. In the head section, you are just calling the link. Link REL is equal to style sheet. A type is whether it may be a text file or CSS file. H reference, the name of the file is, reference file is style.css. So this name should be the same, whatever the name you have saved here. Okay, no changes. Style.css, style.css. Head section should be closed. Body, this is heading. H1. So the page should be in blue color. The output, all the pages in the website should be in blue color, and wherever the heading is there in the pages, that heading should be in which color? This is a heading. The heading should be in pink color. This is heading. So I had used, suppose I had used H1 in only in this page. So in this page, the heading should be appeared in pink color. So wherever, in whatever the page the head that H1 is using, there the color should be pink color. So this is about the different ways that cascading style sheets can be inserted in HTML document. Thank you.